Hello, my name is Francisco Quirela. I am the Americas Tech Responsible at 7 Solutions, and today I will present White Rabbit to high accuracy. This presentation resumes the road of White Rabbit with the main challenges that we found at the very beginning of this technology and the latest developments that have allowed this technology to be part of the new revision of the PTP standard in the high accuracy default profile. White Rabbit is an ultra-accurate implementation of the standard IEEE 1588 PTP. This technology is able to achieve sub-nanosecond accuracy in Ethernet networks, avoiding calibration issues in local area deployments. This technology allows to scale to thousands of nodes and is also interoperable with different time synchronization mechanisms like NTP, PTP, and POST per second distribution. White Rabbit is a resilient time synchronization mechanism which is not affected by GNSS disruptions and provides unprecedented frequency distribution capabilities in the order of 50 picoseconds precisions. The White Rabbit project started in 2008 as a collaboration between public scientific facilities and private companies. And in 2011, the first specifications were released, where White Rabbit was a technology based on previous standard technologies. As a novel technology, White Rabbit faced some challenges to be adopted by the industry. The first one was its maturity level, as it was a new technology with a complex design. The second issue was the standardization, because although White Rabbit is based on standard technologies, it is still a custom solution. In this sense, some industries didn't adopt White Rabbit because they thought that the technology was risky in terms of reliability and also on the continuity of the different hardware that they could find in the market. In terms of interoperability, when we are working in the industry, we find heterogeneous networks where we need to synchronize devices which are not White Rabbit compliant. For this reason, it is important that the White Rabbit devices support different protocols to be interoperable with previous devices in the network. On the other hand, calibration is also an important matter because White Rabbit supported local area synchronization without any kind of calibration. But when we move to longer distances or different networks, there the calibration is a needed stage. Additionally to that, the adaptability of the technology is important as you need to provide a solution which is able to be managed and monitored in production networks. And this requires some tools that need to be added to the White Rabbit devices. The last point was the robustness of the devices, supporting failover, holdover mechanisms, or also redundancy on the hardware to ensure that the operation of the devices was a 24/7 operation. The first issue that we found when we were working with White Rabbit to make it a reference technology in the industry was its maturity level. White Rabbit was a newborn technology which achieved sub-nanosecond accuracy. This level of accuracy was even more than more of the industries were looking for and was kind of difficult to explain or to justify why White Rabbit was a suitable solution for them. However, now White Rabbit is a technology which is 10 years old that has been greatly validated in the scientific field and in the metrology field, but a technology that has been also integrated by other industrial sectors like finance or telecoms during the last years. White Rabbit is now a mature technology with a full White Rabbit community working to evolve its capabilities day after day. And thanks to that, White Rabbit has been used as the reference to develop the new high accuracy profile, which has been integrated in the latest revision of the PTP standard. The standardization of the White Rabbit technology has been possible thanks to the fact that White Rabbit was based on the PTP standard. White Rabbit was a very accurate implementation of PTP, and this very accurate implementation of PTP included some different mechanisms that were responsible of this accuracy improvement. Right now, these mechanisms has been adopted by the new revision of the PTP standard to develop a high accuracy profile, which offers better accuracy numbers in the most evolved applications that use PTP. Some of the mechanisms that have been adopted by the PTP standard are, for example, the layer one synchronization or the calibration. With the layer one synchronization, what we do is to distribute a frequency reference from one device to the rest of the network, so all of them have and share the same frequency. Thanks to that, White Rabbit, or in this case, the high accuracy profile, is able to improve the resolution or the precision of the timestamps that it is performing during the PTP packet exchange. Additionally, and thanks to the calibration values that we use in the White Rabbit protocol, we can adjust the timestamps that we are receiving to remove any kind of delays or uncompensated asymmetries in the links. These and some other mechanisms are the key mechanism that have been right now adopted in the technology, and that makes White Rabbit the reference for this new high accuracy profile, ensuring the continuity of these mechanisms, and also the foreseeable increasement in the use and development of devices that support these capabilities. In terms of interoperability, the White Rabbit community has developed a full ecosystem of White Rabbit devices. Some of these devices support different time synchronization technologies like NTP, PTP, pulse per second distribution, or IDFB. Additionally, the White Rabbit community has worked to integrate White Rabbit capabilities in some other hardware from other vendors. Some examples regarding the interoperability that the White Rabbit devices can provide using standard PTP. Here with the default profile, we can see how we can synchronize PTP slaves with an approximate time synchronization in the order of plus minus 15 nanoseconds. By using different configurations, like for example the telecom profile, the White Rabbit devices are able to provide time synchronization with errors around the plus minus 4 nanoseconds. But if we add synchronous Ethernet, then we are able to achieve time synchronization errors in the order of plus minus 1 nanoseconds when we are synchronizing devices which are not White Rabbit compliant. In terms of pulse per second distribution, the accuracy that we are able to achieve depends a lot on the clock circuitry of the slave that is receiving these pulses. We are able to achieve results in the order of tens of nanoseconds, but in the most evolved cases, we are able to achieve sub-nanosecond accuracy. This is something that you can find in the use case from Deutsche Börse, where they were able to synchronize dozens of devices with a White Rabbit network providing pulse per second to different devices. You can find more information in the link in this slide. Another alternative is being able to integrate high accuracy type synchronization in devices which are not White Rabbit compliant. For this purpose, the high accuracy timing IP core can be integrated in third-party devices which are based on FPGAs to achieve sub-nanosecond accuracy using as a reference White Rabbit devices. Regarding calibration, we need to distinguish between two different scenarios. The first one is when we can provide pre-calibration values for the White Rabbit links. In those cases, the White Rabbit devices automatically reach this sub-nanosecond accuracy. This scenario is the typical when we are working in local area scenarios, but also applies for some long-distance link where we regenerate the White Rabbit signals. However, there are other cases where we need to to perform on-site calibration because of the optical fiber architecture or because of the distances. In those cases, thanks to the precision of the White Rabbit network and the White Rabbit technology, the calibration procedure is easier than using other technologies which are less precise. If you want to learn more about this topic, you can check the talk Resilient Synchronization in White Rabbit Networks presented by Carlos Valenzuela in the ITSF. Even when White Rabbit devices are very precise, the White Rabbit community has worked to develop White Rabbit devices which are even more precise. These devices are the low jitter White Rabbit devices and are able to provide and distribute frequency reference through the network with better noise figures. This is useful for the scalability of White Rabbit networks, reaching more hops and more distance, and provides better specifications for radar or spectrum sharing applications. In terms of adaptability, the White Rabbit ecosystem now supports multiple management and monitoring tools. This was important to ease the integration in production networks, so an effort has been made to improve all these tools to make White Rabbit devices as easy to manage as any other network device that you might find. Additionally, to improve the adaptability of the White Rabbit technology, the evolution to higher bandwidths have been evaluated, for example, with the 10G Ethernet support, and timing performance similar to previous White Rabbit devices has been shown. Lastly, the White Rabbit devices have improved their robustness. The goal here is to be able to support multiple timing sources, and in case that one of the timing sources fail, we can use a backup one. For that reason, we have developed the Time Manager tool, which is an algorithm that selects which time source should be the reference for the device at any moment. If we have multiple time sources available in the device, then the Time Manager will choose which one is the primary one, and if that reference fails, will jump to a secondary source. But if we have only one available timing source and it fails, then the Time Manager will force the device to jump to the holdover status, where we have integrated a very accurate oscillator that will maintain the time error bounded during a certain amount of time. This has been all in this talk. As you can see, we have made a revision of the history of the White Rabbit technology, the different challenges that we have faced, and the different developments that have been performed to overcome those challenges, making White Rabbit a feasible technology, which is the basis for the new high accuracy profile included in the latest PTP release. If you want to contact us, we are available during the show, and if you have any questions, I am here answering you in the chat, so please feel free to contact me. Thank you so much.